Hello students, how are you doing? Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Ramesh Chandra Devrat from Indian Institute of Tourism and Travel Management, Gwalior. Today, we are going to study the module Principles of Interpretation under the paper Two Guiding Essentials. We bring this course to you as a part of ePathshala initiative of the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, to make postgraduate education accessible to all. Discussion during the previous modules has led to a solid foundation in terms of visitor interpretation, concept, types of visitor interpretation. In this module, we take up another important discussion on principles of interpretation. We will straight away begin with the concept of interpretation. In this module, we will also discuss about the important techniques to be considered in interpretations and the importance of interpretations to tour guides in tourism industry. As an important discussion, we will also have a look on various principles of interpretation. This will be the last part of our discussion in this module. Interpretation refers to the process of explaining the meaning of something to an audience. Tour guides should be very clear about the principles and techniques of interpretation because they will have to interpret and communicate facts to different types of tourists throughout their career. Facts should be explained in a way that is understandable to the tourist. The definition of interpretation is the action of explaining the meaning of something. Students, in any interpretation or message process, there is a sender who sends the message. The medium through which the message is transmitted, the person to whom the message is being sent, the feedback to the communication. Now we will have brief introduction to the principles of interpretation. As we know, tourist activity can disturb the activities of the local environment. Tour guiding interpreters have a management role in a tourist destination. They have the duty to ensure that the natural resources of the tourist site is protected. Tour guiding interpreters explain the local rules for visitors' behavior. Tour guides entertain the tourist by providing them with the true meaning of the tourist site. They help the tourists understand their roles, responsibilities, and limitations in the tourist destination. This will help the tourist to appreciate, understand, and enjoy the destination in a better manner. We will now understand about introduction to techniques of interpretation. Tour guides use unique techniques to convey message about the natural, cultural, management, and recreational resources of a tourist site. First of all, the interpreter considers the quality of the audience they are dealing with. They create a story that provides with the message that is relevant to the audience. The message or story will be one that creates some kind of awareness about the region. This message also triggers the required call to action from the audience, like creating a required thought, response, reaction, or action from the tourist. This kind of communication is an art. It is an important skill that tour guides should develop. This skill can be learned and mastered by the repeated practice of interpretation. Principles and techniques. Students, there are four major things to be considered by the interpreter, like what is the interpretive message to be communicated to the audience? Second, who are the audiences? Third, what environment is one located in? Next is, what interpretation technique will be used to convey the message? The interpretation technique that will be used to convey a message can be a personal interpretation technique or a non-personal interpretation technique. In personal interpretation, there are techniques involving a human component. Some of the examples are guided tour, point duty, where a guide remains in one of the place, roving, a guide moves around, presentations, lecture talks, living history, drama, reenactment, interactive. Let's now know a bit more about personal interpretation technique. Personal interpretation techniques will involve a human being who will directly communicate to the visitors. The guide will personally have a face-to-face communication with the tourist. They will give direct explanations and lectures. This is a very personal form of communication, and it will be made in a language that is understandable by the audience. The communication pattern will be modified to suit the audience. If the visitor has challenging medical conditions like visual or hearing impairment, then the communication pattern will be modified by the interpreter. The guide will take questions, chats, and jokes from the visitors. This is a very strong communication pattern because the interpreter moves at the pace of the visitor. It is possible to get direct feedback from the visitors. Personal interpretation is very important for the guided tour. The guide remains in one place, that is the point of duty, or the guide moves around making presentations, lectures, talks, reenacting historical events, being interactive, etc. Lack of attention leads to lack of learning. Therefore, it is very important for the tour guide to do what it takes to help the visitors pay attention to the interpretation. When you are delivering a personal interpretation, the message should be tailor-made to suit the audience type. Any kind of communication should be made in the language that it is understandable by the audience. It should be like poetry. Poetry here represents the following: P for purposefulness, O for organized, E for enjoyable, T for thematic, and R for relevant. Let's start with the first P, purposefulness. Purposefulness experiences for visitors happen with learning by doing. These experiences involve asking questions that have significance in the life of the person undergoing the direct experience. Tourists develop ideas, concepts, and generalizations about their visit to a tourist destination. They develop the meaning from the first-hand experience at the destination, and they improve their level of thinking from their understanding of the concept. When the tourist is learning by observing and not by doing, the accurate personal interpretation made by the tour guide helps the visitor to understand the happening in a clear manner. Then comes O, which is organized interpretation. Helps the tourist remember facts very easily. What comes before and what comes after should be clearly explained. Next is enjoyable. Enjoyable interpretation improves the sensitivity of the concentration of the listener to what is being explained. When real things and real-time instructions materials are used, the sensitivity is greatly improved. Now the next one is thematic interpretation. It is important to help the visitor understand what is actually meant by a drive, emotion, sentiment, happening, or event in a particular place. R The last one stands for relevant interpretation. It will avoid the tourist from widely imagining the meaning of a happening. Thematic interpretation is very important to avoid wrong perception of events. The same event can be understood in a different manner by different people. It is the role of the tourist to help the audience to understand the events in a way that is should actually be understood. Let's talk about the importance of tour guides now. A human communication process makes it possible for everyone to be able to speak, share, and contribute in the discussions. The tour guide will be able to take to questions, chats, and jokes. They respond to the requirements of the audience. The tour guide makes use of conceptual or methodological approaches and techniques in the interpretation process to help the tourists. Therefore, in presence of a tour guide and a little bit known personal interpretation with brochure and media, the tourist is enriched with an understanding to the tourist destination and their role in the tourist destination. Tour guides provides interpretation about heritage. They provide visitors with intellectual and effective access to the cultural and ecological significance of places, objects, and cultural systems in a place. A responsible simulation of ideas and opinions will encourage the protection, preservation, and appreciation of resources and culture for the present and future generation. Students, there are 13 interpretive principles. First one is, the interpretation should be directly talk about what is being displayed or described. It should relate to the personality, type, and experience of the visitor. If the interpretation does not obey this rule, then the experience of the visitor will become blank and unresponsive. Second one is, information is not interpretation. Interpretation is a revelation that makes use of information to express the intended concept. The third one is, interpretation combines several materials, facts that can be scientific, historical, or architectural in nature to express the required information. The fourth is, interpretation is an art that can be taught to a certain degree. The main aim of interpretation is to instruct the tourist about how they have to behave in a tourist destination without making them angry. The fifth is, interpretation addresses the whole matter. It should not talk about just one part of the matter in a phase or process. Sixth is, interpretation made to children should not be just a dilution of facts made to adult tourists. There should be a definite approach dealing with tourists. Interpretation for children will need a separate program. Seventh is, interpretation should be well organized and appropriate to reveal a specific theme. Eighth is, interpretation by the tour guide should help with self-development, self-esteem, love, belonging, social interactions, security, safety, air, food, shelter, etc. Ninth is, interpretation should identify a specific issue and address it wholly. It should be based on one whole idea. Tenth is, the overall purpose of interpretation should be conveyed in a simple and interesting manner without the use of unnecessary jargon and complicated words. 11th is, interpretation should have a clear objective. It should be tailor-made for a specific type of audience and location. 12th is, the method of presentation should be practiced well. 13th and the last one is, the information provided should be true and well researched. As per Tilden, there are six principles of interpretation. The first principle is any interpretation that does not somehow relate what is being displayed or described to something within the personality or experience of the visitor will be sterile. The second principle is information as such is not interpretation. Interpretation is revelation based upon information, but they are entirely different things. However, all interpretation includes information. The third principle is interpretation is an art which combines many arts. Whether the materials presented are scientific, historical or architectural, any art is in some degree is teachable. The fourth principle is the chief aim of interpretation is not instruction but provocation. The fifth principle is interpretation should aim to present a whole rather than a part and must address itself to the whole man rather than any face. The sixth principle is interpretation addressed to children, say up to the age of 12, should not be dilution of the presentation to adults, but should follow a fundamentally different approach. To be at its best, it will require a separate program. When interpreting something, the tour guide should be clear about the audience type. The type of audience to be addressed is very important. The audience can be made up of one or more types of the following. There could be young adventure tourist, jetist tourist with interest in aviation, aeronautics, technology and more, guiding gurus, energy healers who are typically the eat, pray and love type of travelers, armchair tourist, techie travelers, party travelers, minimalist travelers who carry a small luggage with them, older couples, younger couples, families traveling with children, repeat travelers who have been here last year, the complaining traveler who do things by schedule, group travelers, solo travelers who need a gym wherever they go, talkative travelers who talk to everyone they come across, beach travelers who go with the flow and travel without a plan, mall travelers who travel only little money and will want to buy everything at the mall and they are going to be in this place for only for once, budget travelers who have been saving to make the trip possible, the traveler who is not sure of where to go, guidebook travelers who follow the guidebook rules strictly. They dine at the places that the guidebook approves of. No, it all travelers who believes that they know more than the tour guide. Itchy feet travelers who want to travel and do something different. Vintage voyagers who want to create travel albums from vintage places. And there are many more also. The interpreter should have a clear idea about what type of audience they are dealing with. They need to interpret facts to suit the audience type and their needs. The suggestion provided by the interpreters will help the tourists decide whether a specific tourist destination is worth visiting to suit their taste or not. If you are a tour guide who is going to interpret facts to your audience, you have to be very clear about why you will be conducting an activity. The tour guide should be very clear about the outcome they are willing to achieve. They have to be clear and simple. The objective should be simple and easy to understand. The objectives should be suitable for the audience type, locations they are willing to visit. The objective should be measurable. Objective should focus on knowledge, the understanding skills, and the ability of the participants to appreciate their visit that has been carefully planned to suit their personality type. The core interpretive technique is to involve the tourist. When you are demonstrating facts of your audience as a tourist guide, you should involve the tourist in your conversation. You should have the capability to catch hold of the attention of the speakers. You should be willing to take questions, and you should get people to do thinking. As a tour guide interpreter, you should be able to show people the big picture in the travel process. You should be able to explain how something works and how it is done. When you're using complicated jargons and big words, you should be able to give a clear explanation for it. The interpretations that you give should be accurate, tasteful, legal, safe, and viable. It should be something that is true, involves and tourist and innovative to make the facts interesting and easy to remember. Smiles, questions, responses are proof that you have involved your participants. There are four major types of interpretation techniques used by interpreters in different tourist settings. They are consecutive interpretations, simultaneous interpretation, whispered interpretation, and sight translation. Let's talk about consecutive interpretation first. In a situation where the speaker and the recipient speak two different languages, there is a clear need for an interpreter who knows both the languages. Consider a situation where the speaker speaks language 1, the listener speaks language 2, and the interpreter speaks language 1 and language 2. The interpreter serves as a bridge to help speaker 1 communicate to speaker 2. A little bit of extra time is required in this process because the interpretation takes place only after the speakers pause. In the consecutive interpretation process, the speaker talks and pauses, wait for the interpreter to communicate the matter to the end listener. Once the spoken matter is conveyed, the speaker continues to speak, then pauses for the interpreter to communicate the message. If the listener has anything to say, the interpreter conveys that to the speaker in the speaker's language, and the conversation continues until the required communication has taken place. This is a very commonly required communication technique for tour guides. Second is simultaneous interpretation. In simultaneous interpretation, the interpreter will be making translations as the speaker is still speaking. This is a real-time interpretation process. The interpreter should have a strong command of the language of interpretation, the languages which the subject matter is being delivered, and as well as an expertise in the actual subject matter. There is no extra time required because the interpretation is taking place simultaneously as the main speaker continues to speak. Simultaneous interpreters sit in a soundproof booth and they continue to interpret what the main speaker is speaking of in a conference or seminar simultaneously through a microphone. Those is the audience who can understand the main speaker, listen to the main speaker directly. Those in the audience that cannot understand the main speaker listen to this simultaneously interpreter via headphones. The audience with language interpretations requirements plug in their headphones to the interpreters and they listen to the interpreters as and when needed. Simultaneous interpretations does not involve the direct involvement of the main speaker. This is an interpretation comfort provided to those who cannot directly understand the main speaker. Several conferences, seminars, and government meetings provide these services for their ministers and scholars. Now let's see what is whispered interpretation. Simultaneous interpretations techniques require advanced communication tools in the absence of the setup for simultaneous communication. In this process, the interpreter whispers the interpretation in the ears of one or two people who require to translation process. This interpretation happens simultaneously as the speaker continues to speak. However, the communication is in the form of a whisper directly into the ears of the listener. This is commonly used when the interpretation is done for a small group. Since this interpretation is also done simultaneously, a lot of time will not be spent in the process. A tour guide can whisper translations when meeting with the locals of a tourist destination and helping the locals communicate to the visitor. Last technique is sight translation. This is about translating a text from a source language to the target language in the presence of an interpreter. When the audience cannot directly read and understand text from a different language, the interpreter will do the translations to communicate the fact to the tourist. This kind of services will be very commonly required in reading the sign post in a different language in a tourist destination, translating menus, reading the bus routes. They are just a few name of services provided by the tour guide by way of sight translation. If the audience has any questions or clarification, a skillful interpreter will be able to clarify the issue with further elaborate explanation. This is a very common need because not all tourists understand fact in a single interpretation. They are forever looking for translations. This is possible only with a human interpreter. Students, I hope till now you have understood the principles of interpretation. As we all know, tour guide interpretation is an invaluable service. Any visitor who is able to take help from a tour guide will be able to experience the trip in a trouble-free manner without having to deal with the many problems that might arise out of miscommunication or lack of communication skills. The tour guide making the interpretation should do so by obeying the principles of interpretation. The most appropriate technique of interpretation should be used in the process. Not all interpretation techniques are suitable for all types of audience. The type and mode of interpretation should be selected by considering the types of audience. Communication should be made by taking it into consideration the personal strength and weaknesses of the audience involved. Translations and interpretations should be made in a language understandable by the audience. The message should be made into a story that is easy to understand and remember for the audience. The interpretation should create the desired thoughts, response, reaction, and action in the tourist. It should not create wrong and wild perception. The success of any communication process lies in making the tourist believes what the concept, place or situation truly means. Interpretation is meant to avoid wrong perception. In the next session, we will talk about how to develop good interpretation skills. Thank you and happy learning.